Boy, we got a barn burner tonight. Sword and Soul versus something that could swallow your soul.
Nerd Soul.
Late ill kid at one, y'all still holding it down, bringing that street geek and nerd. So what is up, my people, today? Oh yeah, coming with another wonderful episode of, that's right, specials and talk shops, because we got comics in the house. And we have a great little Kickstarter competition coming through. In the right corner, wearing nothing but the illest of Sword and Souls, Changa and the Jade Obelisk. In the left corner, wearing nothing but a fly dress shirt and a skinny tie, Crescent City Monsters. Now, I have had the chance to check out both of these in various ways. I've got to see some previews from Changa. I've got to see issue one of Crescent City Monsters. And today we're gonna talk about, you know, what they both got going on, which one, you know, which one might win out. They both got their Kickstarter going on. You can check those links below and go on and support to find out which one is for you. Now, let me ask you real quick, what comics you been reading lately? Because if you're thinking about that Sword and Soul, let me tell you about Changa. Changa is this beautiful, traveling, seafaring, East African to Asia and South Africa, Sword and Soul epic, where the pearls of the sands of Africa are intertwined with adventure, with villainy, with enough swords and enough action. And a big shout out from, of course, some special folks like your boy M'Baku. Now, on the other side, if you're into that supernatural horror, that supernatural action, we got Crescent City Monsters. You know, you chilling, you minding your business. You a young man, you just want to play instruments. That's all you want to do. You just want to be a musician. Minding your business, you know a little bit about magic. You ain't trying to hurt nobody. But people keep coming after you. And you know, hey, when they come after you and your girl, you got to throw down. Mm-hmm. You got to throw down. So why are we doing this? Well, we got 133 Art with Changa having a fun little back and forth banter with, of course, Dream Fury Comics for Crescent City Monsters. And it's kind of something like this.
I think, you know, our backers are probably the greatest backers in Kickstarter history. You know what I'm saying? Like, they got us there in 3 days, which, you know, so grateful to my people. You know what I'm saying? That's our people.
Yeah. Your backers are all right, but, you know, my backers are pretty good too, man. I mean, I think they blow any group of backers out the window. You know, I don't think. Your backers are okay. I'm not. But don't sleep on my backers, man.
I'm not sleeping. I'm just saying, you know, like, again, they got us there in 3 days, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, we hit that 35 real quick. We went from 0 to 100, you know?
Right? You know, okay.
It was really good.
Okay, you know, I give you that. But you know what? You know what? Let's see whose backers are really the strongest. Let's see who pushes through. What if we do a little competition?
That's right, competition. And competition brings out the best, right? The best backers. Who has the best backers? I don't know. You know, Jason Reeves says that, you know, 133 Art has the best backers. But, you know, some people don't believe that, especially if you go knocking around Dream Fury Comics' door, because Newton Lillivoy is like, nah, son, we got the better backer. So my question is to you, which one have you backed? Have you backed either one yet? Are you trying to back both? Yo, we got two awesome books. I mean, look at this art for Crescent City Monsters. I mean, that joint is dope. The black and white serves this horror, supernatural, noir vibe so well. And then check out, of course, the one and only Changa and the Jade Obelisk, where you have this wrapped mystique and mysterious characters with this sword and soul epic kind of feel where we never really get to see that vibe done for us, with us, kind of surrounding our stories and our voices. And it is just unique to see how we would look in those cases. Most of the time you see sword and sandal, that wax stuff, we ain't on that no more. We on sword and soul. And hey, yo, if it's sword and soul, you know, I mean, come on. So guys, right now, the dope thing is we got about a week left for both of these. We got, you know, a few more days for they to finish strong. Going to hit those links below. You got Crescent City Monsters. You got Chonga and the Jade Obelisk. I've had a chance to check out both of them to varying degrees, and I'm a big fan of both. They're a good read, a fun read, and the art is beautiful to look at. So, of course, holla at me. I'm holla at you. Down in them comments, let's talk Crescent City Monsters. Let's talk Chonga and the Jade Obelisk. Let's talk 1-3-3 Art, Dream Fury Comics. Let's talk artists, all that good stuff, and get you something to read, because for real though, they dropping heat. I mean, I ain't gonna lie to you. They are seriously dropping heat. I've been in love with the Crescent City Monsters since I saw the first page. Since I saw the first character design of Chonga, I was sold. And once I heard Sword and Soul, come on, man. Man, get out of here. Come on, man. You know I'm sold on that. So before we get out of here, I gotta give a big shout out to, of course, 1-3-3 Art, Dream Fury Comics, a big shout out to Black Tribbles, to For All Nerds, to Nerds of Color, Double Toasted, Thought Crimes, all you cats out there like Blurtish, pulling it out each and every day and turning that flame on for all of us to enjoy. So guys, keep reading, keep watching, keep hollering at your boy. And from me to you, peace.